Welcome back. If you're using generative AI to create 2D images, here is the next dimension. A great new capability, a ready-to-use pipeline, and multiple utilities published by Intel Apps to demonstrate how to use generative AI to create 3D images. It is the next step in creating automatically or guided virtual worlds. It is beautiful, and you can do it yourself, as I'll show you in a minute. The additional complexity over 2D image generation is not that big. Please see my other video on Stable Diffusion for deeper explanations, but basically, in a very high level, we can encode or extract the features of an image to a latent space. Then we can add noise and train a unit model to iteratively remove that noise, all at the latent space. When we decode the resulting latent space back to the pixel space, we get back the original image. Now we have a model that can denoise an image to a target latent space. After the training process is done, we can do inference. We can guide the denoising process toward a latent space defined by a text prompt. The article, you can find the link below or follow this QR code, describes how to add the third dimension. They treated the depth image as an additional channel or channels to the RGB representation of the image, and were able to create a latent space that can compress both the RGB images and the depth maps. They trained the modified encoder and decoder and then fine-tuned the unit model to eventually produce a result RGB and depth images, which could be done by us at the inference stage, using a text prompt as a regular 2D Stable Diffusion. If you navigate to the Hugging Face page, I'll leave you the link, you can see the article and all the explanations. If you'd like to look at the actual pipeline code, you will see that the diffusion process is almost the same. LDM3D has almost the same number of parameters as the original Stable Diffusion, but can generate both image and depth. Let's take the code and try to run it as is. So I'll place the code in a Python script, I'll get the ready pipeline from pre-trained, and I'll run it on my Xeon CPU. Here is my prompt, run the pipeline, and save the RGB and the depth images. And it's running, and I have the two images generated. Let's make it faster. Let's import the Intel extension for PyTorch as IPEX. Please see my other video on IPEX, and change the target device to XPU. My GPU will be selected automatically, and run. That's much better. So I got my RGB and the corresponding depth image, and there are multiple ways to actually see the scene in 3D. You'll find the instructions online, but here is maybe the easiest way. I'll leave you the link below to the Hugging Face utility that will allow you to get a prompt in and other parameters and view the result image in 3D. Many parameters to play with, and I'm back at the Italian Dolomites. A great advancement by Intel Labs, 3D generative AI. Enjoy, subscribe. Thank you.